Okay, let's build a Hello World Cordova app using jQuery Mobile. If you haven't installed Cordova yet, head on over to cordovaapache.org. Go to Quick Links, then Documentation, and follow the directions here for the installing the command line interface. It's pretty simple. Install Node, run this line, and you're pretty much done. The next thing you need to do is go to the platform guides and install the platforms that you're interested in targeting. We're going to be using iOS and Android in these tutorials, so you probably want to install at least one of those. Once you've got that, you now have the Cordova command line available to you. All of the commands start with Cordova. To create an application, we'll use Cordova create. The name of the directory. A unique name based on your reverse DNS and a human readable name for the app. And then we'll go into that directory. And we have to install our platforms as well with Cordova platform. I'll add iOS. And Android. Let's take a look at the folder structure it created. So we're going to be doing all of our work in this www directory, which lays out a very simple web application. The rest of these are made by the build process, and we won't need to go into there very often. Let's open this up. And you'll see that it created a configuration file using our unique name, and we need to fill in these application description, author, and so forth. And you'll see that our application starts with index.html, and here it's given us a sample app to start with. We're going to pare it down a little bit and convert it to using jQuery Mobile, and that's fairly simple. First thing we're going to do is we're going to follow this advice here for iOS 7 apps, and basically what that wants us to do is remove these two attributes. And we're going to get rid of that. I have set up some libraries beforehand that we're going to use, and I'll show you how to get those at the end of this video. But bring them in, and essentially, we're going to use jQuery Mobile in this tutorial, and the others we'll use later. So let's bring those into our project. This is jQuery and jQuery Mobile, and I'm using the minimized scripts. Write that down. And I'm also going to bring this index.js up a little. Now, to get started with jQuery Mobile, we need to create divs for each screen of our application. So the way we do that is with a div with a data role set to page and a unique ID. Each page can have three sections. The first section is a header. And the next section is the content. And we could also have a footer. I'm not going to use that in this example. In the header, we'll most likely want a title bar. We'll do that with an H1. And we can put any HTML content we want in here. We'll learn about jQuery Mobile's components, but for now we'll just use a regular H2. And we've now got a minimal app. If I go here, I can view that app in a browser by calling Cordova serve, which will copy our assets into a staging area and set up a local web server for us. What I'm going to do is bring out a special tab for that that's a little smaller, and we'll see that we actually have to go to one of our platforms in the www directory in there in order to get to the app, and here it is. The final result of this section of tutorials is available in GitHub. If you head over to the Appomat area and look at this jQuery Mobile Cordova template project, you'll see directions on getting the libraries and setting up the sample project. The next few videos will take you through the rest of the changes.